said, he said, well, it's only going to run for 2 more months, do what you want. And so I started writing those questions, and it ended up running for, like, on and off 18 years.
Yeah, so the match came into New York, and it was dead serious, the question.
Yeah.
And then when it came back, the big match came 72 or 78, it was close to double entendre, which was hysterical. So you know, were you the producer, or you just wrote the question?
No, I wrote the question.
And you did that for years.
I did it alone in New York for 7 years, and then when I shot to California, I told Kutcher I really wanted to stay in the city. He said, well, I have an office in New York, just write from here, and then they added three writers in California.
So you would write the question and turn it about how many times I mean, obviously, the repeated questions like after a year or so, they do.
Well, we repeated them after a couple of years, but when they first hired me, they wanted 5,000 questions before they went on the air. So they hired me 4 months before the show started, and I was writing 200 to 300 questions a whole week.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
I love Pete Redwood, was the greatest guy.
Ray Bird was super. Just amazing. They were great friends. And then one day, I was in the dressing room, and he said, Dick, I got a call for the Tonight Show. I'm going to do the Tonight Show for a week while Carson's traveling. I said, oh, it's great. And he said, well, you know, you're always doing crazy things on the Match Game. Why don't you think of something you want to do on the Tonight Show?
But let me point out, you did these crazy fastballs. It's another famous one that you want to mention. Before Chevy Chase, you were the expert at this. These fastballs, how did you do that?
Well, you know what? First of all, I had studied judo for a lot of years. I caught a new kind of ball. And the very first practice was one of my favorite things in my life. I sit finally with the camera, giving the stagehand questions, the backstage questions to give the opinion. And Lauren McCall was on, and Lauren McCall and I were great. We had a lot of laughs in the makeup room. And I think the biggest thrill of my life is one day I said, so Lauren, and she said, oh, please call me Betty. My friends call me Betty. So I was sitting off camera, and Lauren came out, and Jean said, Lauren, sit down. Because the introducer, she was just standing there. She said, you know, I'm in love with Vicki Borzola. So I saw the camera go on, and I jumped, and I fell off my chair, and I knocked all the matchsticks in the air, and it got a huge laugh. And keeping that in mind, when Rayburn said, do something on the Tonight Show.
Oh, don't give away the cool.
Oh, yeah, okay. And Rayburn sets it up perfect.
That
magazine
clip is up online. It's on YouTube, too.
Yes. You know what? Chelsea Thrasher. I searched that clip for, what is it, like 67, you know, like 40 or 50 minutes. And I had it in kinescope form. But no one could get the kinescope into video. And one day, out of the blue, Chelsea emailed me and said, are you interested in a copy of this Tonight Show clip? And I emailed back and said, give me a phone number, I have to call you instantly. It turns out she was helping a guy who was writing a book about Gene Rayburn's career. And they uncovered that clip.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Yeah.
Hey, also, we're out of time. You were the Mickey Solar for many years, one of the top guys writing for Man.
Yes, I won the record of Man. I've been in every single issue of Man magazine for 50 years.
And you did, among other things, great TV parodies and all that stuff.
I read a lot of the movie takeoffs, you know, and the TV shows, exactly.
Boy, you guys remember how this guy's a legend. He can keep our solo match game back time for you. Do you do any other shows?
I worked on To Tell the Truth, and I worked on Watch My Wine. Match game was off for more than a month, but he was like another show, go do something.
And everybody knew that name, Mark, too, but he was not exactly the warmest, sweetest, fuzziest guy.
Well, kind of a great voice.
Yeah,
but you knew him, too.
Well, what a career you've had. We'll call you back sometime.
Okay.
Let's go to Chris, New York City. Hey, Chris.
Hey, how the time that they had that thing about the prostitutes on the badges and
stuff.
So he admitted that they were investigating him.
Yeah.
How do they investigate the 911